Most observers believe they understood what Israel brought to the table in its emerging war with Iran. Devastating aerial power, thanks to fighter jets and munitions provided by the US, has allowed Israel to batter Iran into near submission in just a couple of days. But here's what hadn't been known. Israel has lasers. And these unconventional weapons are starting to make their presence known as the conflict started by Israel's Operation Rising Lion reaches the end of its first week. A high-energy laser has been used for the first time in actual warfare. And this is what happened. Rafael Advanced Defense Systems, which is an Israeli weapons manufacturer, announced what it dubbed a world first. It confirmed that last year, Israel had used a special aerial defense weapon named the early model of Iron Beam to take out a horde of drones unleashed onto its territory by Hezbollah. For the first time in history, high-power laser systems have been used to intercept aerial threats, Rafael wrote on X. This unprecedented breakthrough took place during the Swords of Iron War, with Rafael's advanced technology at the heart of the operation. For context, the Swords of Iron War is the name given to the conflict that started when Hamas unleashed its terrorist assault on Israel back in October 2023. Initially involving Israel and Palestine, the war scope has expanded to cover Israel's fights against similar militant groups such as Hezbollah in Lebanon. Rafael's announcement went on to say that the laser interceptors were developed in partnership with Israel's Air Force and its Ministry of Defense, and are now battle-proven to be capable of neutralizing enemy threats with speed, precision, and zero cost per shot. "A new era of warfare is upon us," Rafael exclaimed, before rounding out its X post with a simple statement. "This is not theory. This is real, combat-proven, operational, historic." The X post was accompanied by 30 seconds of footage showing the laser interceptors in action. The new laser systems are seen positioned on the ground, pointing up toward the sky. The footage then switches to a grainy black and white video showing what appears to be a drone hurtling through the air. Suddenly, that drone's wing is on fire and it goes crashing to the ground. The laser system scored a direct hit. The drone was no more. So, there are some details about the first usage of an adapted version of the Iron Beam. But when was it used, and against whom? The Warzone, or TWZ, provides a few more details about the when, stating that Rafael's confirmation of Iron Beam's entry to the battlefield comes months after his first use in October 2024. That's when Israel's new laser made its combat debut, and Rafael has apparently been working on creating the definitive version of the system that will be fielded by the Israel Defense Forces later in 2025. As for the against whom question, that information comes from Popular Mechanics. It says that October 2024 saw Hezbollah, a militant group in Lebanon that the Wilson Center dubs an Iranian proxy, unleash a horde of drones against Israel. Hezbollah claimed that it used its drones to penetrate Israel's airspace without sending off the Iron Beam's radar array, leading to the deaths of four soldiers and injuries to seven more. But those drones weren't 100% successful. The October 2024 assault actually did trigger the Iron Beam, according to the Military Art YouTube channel. With little time to waste, the Israel Defense Forces, supported by Rafael and other agencies, rushed the Iron Beam into operational use, it says. The result was what was captured in the Rafael X post. The laser systems intercepted several airborne threats during Hezbollah's drone assault, taking out unmanned aerial vehicles that would otherwise have bypassed Israel's traditional air defenses. The Military Art calls what happened in October a battlefield baptism. If Rafael is to be believed, that baptism saw the prototypes of the Iron Beam establish itself as the latest addition to Israel's already impressive multi-layered air defense setup. It was a baptism that happened far sooner than Israel anticipated. Israel realized that it needed something more than what it already had after Hamas proved that Israel's other defensive systems, such as the Iron Dome, could be overwhelmed. During its attack on Israel in October 2023, Hamas claims it overwhelmed Israel's air defense systems by firing a staggering 5,000 missiles in just 20 minutes. The incident was a sobering wake-up call for Israel that it needed something else to add to its air defenses, something that could fire quickly, cheaply, and at short range to take down aerial threats that break through the other layers. Israel turned to the idea of deploying something that only ever existed in experimental labs. For decades, militaries around the world have been toying with the idea of introducing lasers to the battlefield. Most have never gotten a real idea off the ground. Israel did. In truth, the Iron Beam system has been in development long before Hamas's October 2023 attack. Back in April 2022, the head of the Israel Defense Ministry's research and development team, Brigadier General Yaniv Rotem, revealed that the Iron Beam had made it through a slew of tests. The Times of Israel says those tests involved shooting down drones, mortars, rockets, and even anti-tank missiles, with Rotem stating that all of these tests were conducted at challenging timings and ranges. The use of a laser is a game changer, and the technology is simple to operate and proves to be economically viable, Rotem added. Footage supporting these tests was released and shared on YouTube by TWZ. At around the 50-second mark, the Iron Beam can be seen in action. Target after target is hit successfully, with some targets blowing up while others, such as a drone similar to that seen in the Rafael video, burst into flames. Still, the Iron Beam wasn't ready in 2022. But when Hamas attacked, Rafael and its partners accelerated the production of the unique laser so that it could be fielded as quickly as possible. Just a year after the Hamas strike, and around 2.5 years after Rotem reported the first successful test, the early model of the Iron Beam was on the field and taking out drones, dozens of them, if Futura is to be believed, though neither Israel nor Rafael have provided any specific numbers. So the basics about Iron Beam and how Israel has used it are clear. Here's how the amazing new laser actually works. Rafael says that the Iron Beam is a 100 kilowatt high energy laser weapon system, or HELWS, that is capable of quickly engaging and eliminating a wide array of threats from a range of hundreds of meters to several kilometers. Futura adds that the definitive version of the weapon, which is anticipated to enter service later in 2025, has a range of about 10 kilometers, which is approximately 6.2 miles. That suggests that HELWS is designed for short-range interception of incoming targets, further hinting at its potential role as a last line of defense against aerial threats that make it through Israel's other air defenses. This will be explored a little later in the video. Rafael also says that the Iron Beam engages targets at the speed of light and has an unlimited magazine, as long as the system stays plugged into an electricity source. Given that electricity is the main source of power and the laser itself requires no construction, that means each shot with the Iron Beam costs almost nothing, especially when compared to the cost of firing a missile to take out an incoming threat. A Rafael brochure also reveals that the Iron Beam is capable of extended tracking of its targets, which is facilitated by what it calls multifunction beam directors, and that it has built-in adaptive optics that ensure stabilization of the laser and its firing unit. And speaking of that unit, the footage available of Iron Beam suggests that it's as simple to use as a large gun. There's a sight through which the user aims, and they presumably pull a trigger or press a button to unleash the high-speed laser once the target is in their sight. That unit also doesn't need to be manned by an operative. Rafael says that the Iron Beam's operator console can be remotely deployed, which can be assumed means an operator can station themselves a safe distance from the laser while still firing on target. Combine all of that with the Iron Beam's ability to rapidly retarget when faced with a swarm threat, and it becomes a weapon that's ideal for dealing with the drones many of Israel's enemies send into the country's territory. And speaking of drones, that leads to the reasons why Israel is building Iron Beam. One of the clearest reasons has already been mentioned several times. Iron Beam is an aerial defense system that's ideal for dealing with hordes of incoming drones. Take Hezbollah as an example. According to the Missile Defense Advocacy Alliance, Hezbollah was reported to have more than 10,000 rockets and missiles in 2006 and had multiplied this already extensive arsenal to reach more than 150,000 by 2016. Nearly a decade later, it's reasonable to assume that Hezbollah has continued to build up and may now have a stockpile of rockets, missiles, and drones that exceeds 200,000. Other militant groups also present a clear aerial threat. Hamas has already claimed to have used 5,000 missiles to overwhelm Israel's air defenses, as mentioned earlier, and there are also drones coming out of Iran to consider. Back in November 2022, just a few months after Israel revealed the first successful tests of Iron Beam, Defense Express said that Iran was likely building up to 150 Shahed drones per month. It makes other drones too, but even accounting only for Shahids, this would amount to around 1,800 drones per year. United Against Nuclear Iran reveals that hundreds of these drones have already made their way into Russia and have been supplied to Iran's Middle East proxies. Countering these threats is where Iron Beam comes into play. Any missiles or drones that are able to circumvent Israel's other air defenses become targets for Iron Beam. That's particularly important for drones, which are often capable of flying below the radars of conventional air defense systems. The Iron Beam isn't a cure-all for the sheer number of aerial munitions that can be shot into Israel by its enemies. However, it does provide another layer of defenses Israel can use to target the most dangerous of these projectiles so it can protect its people. Speaking of Israel's other air defenses, that leads to another reason why Iron Beam is so important. Cost, rather the lack of it. Israel's layered aerial defenses have been mentioned previously. They comprise three key systems: the Arrow system, David Sling, and the Iron Dome. Each serves a purpose. The Arrow is a long-range defense system capable of hitting targets up to 1,491 miles away. Ideally, Israel wants to use that system to destroy incoming ballistic missiles so far away from its territory that not even the debris could cause damage. David Sling is effective at a range of about 186 miles, with the Iron Dome being effective at 43 miles, making them the mid and short range options in Israel's air defense triad. All of this is very impressive, but the equipment used in these systems comes with a high price. Bloomberg highlighted that the price in a June 16 article, in which it covered how much Israel spends to rattle off a single missile against an incoming aerial threat. Every Arrow 3 missile fired by the Arrow system sets Israel back around $2 to $3 million. David Sling and its Stunner missiles are a little less costly, with a price of $1 million per missile fired. The Iron Dome is the cheapest of the three, though its Tamir missiles still cost $50,000 each. In April 2024, the full use of these combined systems showed how much defense can cost. Iran attacked Israel in that month, causing Israel, along with its French, US, Jordanian, and UK allies, to spend an estimated $1.1 billion to repel the attack. That's not a sustainable expenditure, given the sheer number of missiles and drones Iran and its proxies can deploy. And all of this is without even considering the massive amounts of maintenance and the general operational costs required to keep this trio of air defense systems up and running. Then there's the Iron Beam. How much do analysts think it costs to fire a laser at an incoming drone or missile? As noted earlier, the use of the Iron Beam costs almost nothing, per Rafael. The actual cost is anywhere between a couple of dollars and $3.50. Former Prime Minister of Israel, Naftali Bennett, shared the $3.50 figure following the successful April 2022 tests of Iron Beam, posting the following to X. This is the world's first energy-based weapons system that uses a laser to shoot down incoming UAVs, rockets, and mortars at a cost of $3.50 per shot. TWZ suggests that the price per shot may have been pulled down even more since, suggesting that recent reports claim a cost closer to $2.50. Whichever figure is accurate doesn't really matter. Even going with the higher $3.50 per shot claimed by Bennett, that still means Israel can fire the Iron Beam 14,285 times before it matches the cost of a single Tamir missile. If that's the case, the question has to be asked. Why doesn't Israel replace its existing air defense systems with masses of Iron Beams? Well, as impressive as the Iron Beam is, the defense system comes with several drawbacks that mean it can't serve as a direct replacement for any of Israel's other three systems. The range mentioned earlier is a major one. The Iron Beam can hit targets that are 6 miles away at maximum, as Futura claimed, and the reality is that it will probably be deployed at much closer distances. Given that Israel's other air defense systems can hit targets from several dozen to well over 1,000 miles away, replacement with the Iron Beam would force Israel to only engage with aerial threats when they're on the edge of touching down. That's not a risk that's worth taking. There's also the weather issue. It's one thing to deploy Iron Beam in an experimental environment, which allows the operator to fire the weapon when conditions are perfect. Relying on it to serve as an all-weather air defense solution is a much different prospect, one that simply won't work. Lasers are impacted by their environment, As David Schmidt of the University of Illinois, Urbana-Champaign points out, laser beams tend to die out when they encounter fog, smog, heavy rain, and snow. The reason is that all of these things can absorb and dissipate the laser while it's en route to its target. That doesn't necessarily mean the laser can't hit home. However, these weather issues cause severe range reductions that make the ion beam unreliable in anything but clear conditions. Even the temperature distribution of the surrounding air can affect a laser's speed and direction. There are also other drawbacks, as TWZ explained. For instance, ion beam has to be hooked up to a power source at all times if it's going to keep on firing. Any issue with that power source means an end to the laser, meaning an enemy of Israel could target power stations to create blackouts before hitting ion beam installations. Lasers also generate a thermal load on the device being used to fire them. Though the ion beam can theoretically fire thousands of lasers for the cost of a single missile and can do so at the speed of light, the reality is that the weapon will always be limited by this thermal load. How many times can the ion beam fire before it needs to cool down? The answer isn't clear yet, along with not knowing how long the cooldown period has to last. Add into all of this the fact that the weapon's range is further limited to targets that are visible to the human eye, an operator still has to point and shoot, and that adds another range limiter along with the weather and the ion beam's natural range. None of this means that the ion beam isn't useful, it absolutely is. However, these drawbacks do mean that the weapon can't be a replacement for what Israel already has. Instead, as mentioned a couple of times already, it will complement the Arrow, David's Sling, and Iron Dome systems. TWZ suggests that Israel will use the Iron Beam as a point defense system, deploying several of them at key military sites to be used to take out any aerial threats that make it through other air defenses. So, what does Israel really have with its Iron Beam? It has the world's first laser air defense system that has already been successfully tested, both in experiments and on the battlefield thanks to its October 2024 deployment. It also has an incoming definitive version of the system that will arrive later in 2025 and will likely be mass-produced to complement its existing air defenses. The Iron Beam also allows Israel to defend against close-range threats at a tiny fraction of the cost of kinetic air defense solutions. But most importantly of all, the Iron Beam is coming onto the field at the perfect time for Israel. When the country started Operation Rising Lion against Iran, it had to know that an Iranian response was coming. Several have already arrived. On June 15, Al Jazeera reported that Iran unleashed a wave of drone and missile strikes against Israel. June 18 brought with it the news of a pair of overnight Iranian missile salvos. The first launched at 12:40 a.m. local time, contained 15 projectiles, with a second smaller salvo of 10 missiles being launched 40 minutes later. The Times of Israel reports that the June 18 missile attack triggered air alerts, but that most of the missiles were intercepted. More will be coming, and it's possible that Iran's proxies in Lebanon and Palestine will be firing drones, rockets, and missiles along with Iran itself in the future. The Iron Beam's arrival means Israel has another weapon in its arsenal to defend against these types of attacks. However, it remains to be seen just how effective the fully unleashed Iron Beam can be. While Israel is introducing new air defenses into its battle against Iran, the Iranian defenses have crumbled under Israel's aerial might. Check out our video to find out how these failures allowed Rising Lion to be carried out and what they mean for Russia and Iran. And if you like this video, consider subscribing to The Military Show for more commentary on the latest developments in the Iran-Israel war.